The journey is very rough.
It's hell.
Every year, thousands of migrants risk it all trying to make their way to Europe. As they leave their homelands behind them, the possessions they take with them give us a sense of who they are. Some dedicated people on the Italian island of Lampedusa have saved some of those items. I'm here to see if I can trace just one person through one of these lost objects and shed a new light on this dangerous journey taken by so many.
Alcuni portano la terra.
Soil.
Sì, che portano dal proprio paese. Abbiamo trovato diversi di questi pacchetti che è proprio il legame con la propria terra, con l'Africa, no?
Giacomo Sferellasso is one of the founders of a collective that has set up this small informal museum for objects lost by migrants traveling along this route, the deadliest in the world. It's impossible to trace someone through a parcel of soil, but Giacomo helps me with more tangible items.
Questo è un passaporto, c'è anche delle agendine.
Take a shot of this.
Ghana.
Oh, wow! A Ghanaian driver license.
Many, many people.
Yeah, a lot of them. So where are all these people? Where are they?
I can just imagine the pain, the sacrifice and the strength needed to make this journey. A pain that feels in so many ways familiar.
I come from the northern part of the country, and in 1994 there was ethnic conflict. We lost everything. I know how it feels to lose your home and to be far away from home.
Back in Accra, my search begins. I've taken home countless photos of documents, including a driving license and a passport, both from Ghana, and a letter in Amharic. I immediately send these to contacts, and I face an address book with a seemingly endless list of phone numbers.
Citibank call karne ke liye bahut shukriya.
Numero inaki.
Oh God.
Please check the number and dial again. Thank you.
After a few restless months, I receive a couple of responses, but unfortunately, they all lead to nothing. And then one day, I get a call from Mr. Frank Apoti from the Document Fraud Expertise Center of the Ghana Immigration Service.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Welcome, Thomas.
Thank you very much.
Please have a seat. We've been able to establish a link on the name. Oh, that's the good news for you, my brother. Yes.
After bouncing between driver license and passport databases, Mr. Apoti managed to access the phone number for a relative of the driver licenses holder. This is the breakthrough moment I have been waiting for. A number, a tangible connection. And after a brief phone call, I can't believe I'm on my way to Germany to meet the owner of the driving license Giacomo first showed me in Lampedusa many months ago. Like many from West Africa, Richard traveled to Europe via Libya.
The journey is very rough.
It took me, let's say, 2 years from Ghana to Nigeria. Nigerian back to Cotonou, Cotonou to Niger, from Niger, Chad, Chad to Libya. It's hell.
When you finally docked in Lampedusa, what was the feeling like?
I was so weak, very, very weak, but I was still jubilate. Finally, I have seen light.
Now that you are in Europe, is that what you imagined or hoped for?
When I was in Africa, I thought in Europe, things are easy. You get money easy, but it's not like that. You have to work hard. But at home, there was no plan for me to lay my hands on to survive. So I would say that I'm grateful to be here